Hello, and welcome to what I hope is going to be an interesting review. For those of you who saw my post a couple of days ago and managed to correctly guess what this video is about, well done. It is going to be to do with lighting. Now, this is something that I've been threatening to do for a little while now. Some people have asked me about it in a previous Q&A video and in some comments as well. And yes, the plan is eventually to light my Hogwarts castle with some of the kits that are available. Now, I was going to wait a little bit before I did this, but I was recently approached by a company called Lightailing, which I hadn't actually heard of before. There's quite a few companies out there that do custom Lego kits, lighting kits for various sets, as well as individual parts to make your own. And I was approached by them and asked if I would like to have one of their sets to review. And I, of course, said yes, jump at the chance. So that's just, you know, full disclosure, I have been sent this set just here for free to review, but they are not getting final say on the video or checking anything out. So the review is entirely my own and I'm really interested to check it out. So let's get this open. Say open, I have already opened it just to double check. So inside we have got a Bricsmax branded LED lighting kit for set 75980 Attack on the Burrow. Now they gave me my choice of lighting kits out of the quite a few that they do on their website, and I chose this one partly because I think the Burrow would look really good with some lights, and partly because it's one of the few sets that I actually have that's still intact, although I own pretty much all of the 2018 Harry Potter wave and beyond, so 2018 to the present. A lot of them, as you may already know, have been taken apart and used for my Hogwarts. So very long intro over, let's get into this kit. This is one of two different versions of the lighting kit for the Burrow that Lego Lightailing do. I say Lego Lightailing, they may just be called Lightailing. And this one is branded as Bricsmax. There is a slight price difference between the two kits. I can't actually remember exactly how much this one costs. I'll try and put the details down below. Again, not sponsored or anything. I'm not getting any backhanders for this. Literally just, this is the one that I've got. So let's have a little look and see what we get. Am I going to be able to open this with just a nail? It's quite securely packaged. Let me grab something sharp. There we go, with the plastic removed. It's been packaged quite well, actually. It's, I believe, come all the way from China, where the company is based, and it arrived quite quickly as well, which is nice. I don't know what postage it was paid for. So let's open this. It's the first time I'm opening it. So inside, what do we get? We've got what look like a couple of, user guides, basically instructions. We'll take a closer look at them in a minute. And then we get some bubble wrapped, look like foil pouches. Nice sturdy little box, actually. Let's get these not open, you can just pour them out. So we get quite a few different components here. First of all, that looks like that's a AA battery holder, and are those genuine Lego parts? They are genuine Lego parts, that's nice. I don't know if they've got lights in them already or if we attach them later. I will find out later. Got a USB-A connector there. And then these will presumably be various lights. Yep, warm dot connecting cables, white strip lights. Yep, there we can see strips of lights again. So yeah, individually foil packaged. I think you can also buy these individually if you're making your own custom thing, as I may do in the future. Let's just have a look inside here too. So yeah, I've actually got no experience of Lego lighting kits at all. I've done a tiny little bit of research just to see if they're really for me. Just a little bit of gump there. And we've got a couple of booklets. Just take a look inside. Okay, so these are quite nice. Yeah, we've got some nice full colour photos with some instructions, which are... yeah, they're pretty clear by the looks of it. Just having a flick through. Yeah, obviously I need to go through these in detail as I go, but it seems to be fairly clear. Looks like we get some sticky pads to attach some of the LEDs to the underside of some bricks. They're quite thin cables, so I'm wondering whether they go between bricks if they're thin enough, or if it's all been arranged Yeah, I think they must go between some bricks. Yeah, okay. So these are the instructions on how to put it all together. And then, yeah, power comes from batteries. Ah, batteries or USB. That's cool, actually. Yeah, because from the weight of this, I don't think there are any batteries inside, which makes sense, you know, you wouldn't expect there to be. But it's cool that that's USB powered as well, because I can just plug that into a charging outlet. And this is, okay, this is just a little bit about how you position some of the lights and the sticky backs. It's in multiple languages, so I'll definitely have a read through that before I get started, because I don't want to muck anything up. There's another demonstration of how to put batteries in. And yeah, right, there we go. So the next thing we need is the Burrow. And here's the set. I never did a review on this set, but just a very quick one. I really like it. I never had the previous one, so this is the first Burrow I've experienced. But by looking at pictures and other people's comparisons, this pretty much eclipses it in every way possible, even down to the price, where it's really not that expensive for what you get. So yeah, it's a lovely set. And again, that's part of the reason why I thought it would be cool to get a lighting kit for it. It's got a great interior, and I'm hoping that we're going to get some light in pretty much every room. I think it's going to require some deconstruction, but I'll try and give you my verdict on whether it's better to put the light kit in as you build, or whether it's better to build it all up first and then deconstruct. Don't know yet, so we will have a look through the instructions and make a start, and I will give you some updates. Okay, so I've just gone through the first couple of steps. I haven't actually got round to installing any lights yet, but I thought it was interesting to point out. So just looking back at the first page of these instructions, it does actually show the completed model, first of all, in step number two. And then in step number three, it shows you taking a brick separator to it, and then four shows you like that. Now, I think that's quite interesting. That's quite good. Means it's obviously a sort of an aftermarket thing where someone who's already built the set can then come in and change it. It wasn't the hardest thing in the world to separate. Obviously, you know, it's Lego, it's designed to come apart. But in terms of the pieces, this just shows you basically taking all of these top sections off in one. As you can see, I've got one section here, another bit here, and actually I've also got, just reach behind me, this bit here. Now, luckily, this bit is actually designed to come off. If you've built the set, you'll know what I mean. It's got the tiles on the top and then just a couple of studs holding it in. So you can remove this and just forget about it for the moment. And then actually, these bits came off relatively easily. You just want to make sure that these little sub-assembly kind of bits stay together. This is actually only attached with pretty much with hinges, so yeah, it's a little bit delicate, but it comes it comes apart quite easily. So yeah, it's been fairly well thought out. Yeah, right, time to get on with actually putting some lights in. And there we go. Couldn't resist it. It's not actually in the instructions, but I decided I wanted to plug it in, so I've just used the USB there and just plugged directly in there. I think the way it works is that all the lights will be basically chained one to the other, so you don't have to then reroute wires back down. But yeah, that's just one light strip. It's just stuck onto the bottom of a 1x4 reddish brown plate, which is provided. They are genuine Lego pieces, and I think they're all new by the looks of it. So you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 reddish brown 1x4s and 1 1x6 in tan. So yeah, that's one light in, and time to go and get the rest of them done. You can see there where it disappears underneath the brick. It's a little bit in shadow. You can see that the bricks don't quite meet up above. It does show the wire going directly underneath the brick. So yeah, I mean, there's something to be said. Maybe other brands will find a way to weave the cables around, or maybe, to be honest, there just isn't a good way of doing it. But no, it looks nice, and it still enables this to open and close, which is good. So I'm gonna get on, carry on following the instructions, which are pretty clear, and I will join you again once I have, well, to be honest, once I've put all the lights in, unless anything else comes up along the way. And here we go, that's everything done. I have made a little bit of a mess over there, just with the empty packets and the few of the sticky pads that hold everything together. But overall, it was fairly simple. I did have to double check a couple of the steps a few times just to make sense of where everything was. I think that's the disadvantage of using actual photos rather than the renders that Lego uses, for instance. where you can have actual part callouts to show where exactly things have been placed. You know what? It was pretty good actually. Some of the installation isn't particularly neat, but I'm going to say that maybe more to do with me than the actual instructions. But anyway, moment of truth, I've gone for the USB connector and I've got a plug just here, so we can just plug it straight in and there we go. That is really, really impressive. The USB cable is relatively short, so I'm just going to keep it up there and hope that doesn't fall off the table. So there we go. That is everything lit up. I have actually tried this once before off camera just to see. I have noticed that one of my lights just up at the top here, just under there, hasn't lit up. Now, I don't know if that's because it's defective or because I've actually put things together in the wrong way. One thing that I would say is that the plugs are very, very small, and once you've plugged them in, I wouldn't advise taking them out again, at least not too many times, just because they are quite fiddly, and the chances of actually pulling the cable out of the plug seems to me to be quite high. But yeah, the overall effect is really, really nice. We've got lights all throughout the building. So you've got several in the downstairs area, some up here, including one underneath this overhanging bit of floor, in the bedroom up there, in what's Ron's bedroom here, and also right up the roof. I think the actual effect almost looks cooler from the outside, where you can just see the separate windows and rooms being lit up. There isn't too much light bleed through the bricks, actually. There's a little bit when you get up to the window at the top, but there is one directly behind there. So overall, that's actually really, really nice. I'll just open up this front panel as well. So you can see, yeah, that's the first one you can't see because I'm not directing the camera. You can see that's the first one I put in just there. I think it's slightly a shame that some of these lights aren't in better positions. I feel like there's been quite an emphasis put on getting as many lights into this as possible, which is really nice because it creates a good effect, but it does mean that there are an awful lot. Some of them are a little bit more subtle, actually. I'd forgotten that there is actually one in the porch just underneath there, which you can just about see with the Weasleys at the front. So overall it looks really nice. There are a couple of downsides. One I've kind of mentioned already is the fact that a lot of these wires are routed through or kind of under and between bricks, where there isn't really room for them. There are some places where I completely understand why they've had to do it. There isn't space, and they've just wanted to get the cables through in the simplest possible way. But this does mean that there are places like this, for instance. You might be able to just see there's a little bit of a gap because this won't actually go down correctly. Happens in a couple of other places. One place that's particularly obvious are these tiles just here. You can see they're not seated correctly against those modified bricks, and that's because they've actually got cables directly behind them. Just notice that this one has come off. That's the other thing. The sticky pads aren't the best. I think they are just kind of generic ones. They're not specialist or anything. The strip lights sit better than the single lights do. Back to those tiles, you can see there's a tiny little gap behind there, whereas there isn't on this side where there are no cables. So it's a bit of a shame, actually. Also, the other unfortunate thing is that we do have what looks like a sort of junction box, which is actually what it is. It's multiple cables all plugged into one piece, but that does mean that that's quite obvious stuck on the outside. There are actually two of these. The other one is slightly better hidden. Let's see if I can turn this the whole way around. The other one is actually under there. It would be better hidden, actually, if the sticky pads actually held it on. That's a little unfortunate overall that things like that are so obvious. But I have to say, these are, these are things you'll notice just by looking at it really closely. And I think that if you were to display this and look at it from any sort of distance, especially from the sort of, suggested viewing side. So this is basically the exterior, isn't it? And actually looking at it from here, all the lights look pretty good. So I'm really happy actually as far as a first lighting kit goes. It's been really interesting to see all the different components that you can get, all the different bits and pieces. They're very nicely labelled, well organised. There was a slight colour discrepancy between the Lego pieces that were provided in the set and the ones in the instructions, but that doesn't really matter. They're basically just there to hold some of the lights. It's interesting to note actually that not all of the lights are stuck onto new pieces. Some of them are stuck onto existing parts of the model. So, you know, just be prepared to have, there are only tiny points of contact. So if you really don't want them or you don't want to remove them afterwards, it shouldn't be too much of a problem. I'm just going to try one more thing. I'm just going to go turn the main light of the room off. And there we go. That's a better view of it in the dark. In fact, I will just hook the camera up and take a step back. There we go. It's really bright, actually. There's quite a lot of LEDs in there. But yeah, I think that looks really nice and illuminates the mess on my desk even better. So yeah, there we go. That was my first experience of a Lego light kit from Lego Lightailing. So thank you once again for them for sending it to me. It was really fun to put together, and it's definitely made me interested in lighting up my Hogwarts in future. So thank you very much for watching and for being patient for this video coming out. If you have enjoyed, then please leave me a like down below. Maybe suggest if there are any other sets you'd like to see me put some lights in, and also if I should go ahead and start lighting up my Hogwarts, or if you want me to actually get it finished first. Always leave a comment and I'll try my best to get back to you. Leave a like down below, that would really help. I've also got a Patreon, which I will link in the video description if you feel like helping out as well. And until I see you again, have a good one. Bye.